This video was made possible by Wix. If you're ready to create a website, head over to wix.com/go/infographics to try out one of their premium plans right now. On the 8th of November in 2017, American Secret Service agents and their Chinese counterparts were involved in a brief altercation over the American nuclear football while entering China's Great Hall of the People. A Chinese agent blocked President Trump's aide, tasked with carrying the football, only for Chief of Staff and retired U.S. Marine Corps General John Kelly to announce, "We're moving in," and brush past the Chinese guards. A guard grabbed Kelly, who quickly shoved the guard off, and immediately, a U.S. Secret Service agent tackled and subdued the Chinese guard. Though the scuffle was over in a flash, it highlighted the importance of this little black briefcase that must always accompany the president no matter where he goes. But just what is inside of that top-secret briefcase? Hello and welcome to another episode of the Infographics Show. Today we're asking, what is the nuclear football? The head of the Chinese security detail would go on to apologize for the misunderstanding, as apparently the guards had not realized that the aide carrying the nuclear football must always be within easy reach of the US president. While some might think the American response was an overreaction, it only takes a moment to see it from the Secret Service's point of view, to see why they felt the need to respond immediately and with overwhelming force. The US president had just been removed from the nuclear football while in a foreign nation, and a nation to boot who is a potential nuclear adversary. Were something to happen to the US president while he was away from the football, and China launched a preemptive first strike against the US, there would be no way for America to respond in time with its own weapons. A far-fetched scenario to some, but US Secret Service agents must constantly entertain the most extreme possibilities as potential realities every single day. For that is the only way to avert a potential and surprise catastrophe. Thus, it's a standard operating procedure that the nuclear football never be removed from the immediate physical vicinity of the US president. So just what does the nuclear football do exactly, and what's inside of it? This nuclear command and control tool is officially known as the president's emergency satchel, and is an aluminum briefcase encased in black leather. Details are difficult to ascertain given the extreme secrecy of the device, but it is widely believed to be bulletproof and resistant to explosive damage. It weighs approximately 45 pounds and is equipped with powerful satellite communication gear to ensure the president is always in contact with the Joint Chiefs of Staff. As nuclear arsenals grew in the Soviet Union and the US, it became clear that the nation to launch first would have an immediate and possibly war-winning advantage. Such a first strike might even render the defending nation unable to launch its own nuclear counterattack, making the possibility of a nuclear first strike extremely attractive to the aggressor. With ICBMs moving at thousands of miles an hour, it became vital that the President of the United States be able to order an immediate nuclear counterattack in the case of a sudden war. Yet, after the Cuban Missile Crisis in 1962, the President John F. Kennedy posed several questions to his staff, doubting the effectiveness of the current nuclear command system. His most pointed question, however, was, "How would the person who received my instructions verify them?" This one question led to a complete rethinking of how the US president was to order a nuclear attack or retaliation, and highlighted a major flaw in the system set in place for the president to do so while out of the White House. Thus, the modern iteration of the nuclear football was born. A mobile device, the nuclear football contains satellite communications gear that lets the president be in contact with the Joint Chiefs of Staff no matter where in the world he is. It also contains four individual items. The Black Book, as it is known, contains all retaliatory options available to the president. This can include a full-scale nuclear response against one or all of America's enemies, or a limited response which might be just a single cruise missile strike with a low-yield warhead. It's rumored that attack plans also include an option to launch a no-harm nuclear strike high above a nation in the atmosphere, delivering an electromagnetic pulse that wipes out most of a nation's electrical infrastructure. If you're a fan of conspiracy theories, it might also include a plan to nuke the reptilian aliens hiding out in the dark side of the moon. A second book contains a listing of classified presidential nuclear shelter locations, or places that the president could be taken to in case of a major nuclear emergency. These are typically hardened locations deep underground that can survive direct nuclear strikes. A manila folder with 8 or 10 pages that give a description of the procedures to initiate and use the emergency alert system, both for early warning and for post-strike communications with the nation. Lastly, a 3x5-inch card with printed authentication codes. These codes ensure to the Joint Chiefs of Staff that the person ordering a nuclear attack is indeed the US president. And while they typically stay within the football, some US presidents, such as President Reagan, actually preferred to physically carry his cards in his pocket. During the assassination attempt, against Reagan when he was rushed to the hospital. Not only was he physically separated from the football, but as his clothes were cut off in surgery, the nuclear codes were haphazardly discarded by medical staff and later found stuck in his shoe. But just how does the football actually work? And what process would the president have to undergo to launch a nuclear strike or retaliate against one? Firstly, only the current president of the United States is authorized to launch any form of nuclear attack, whether that's as retaliation or an escalation during the middle of a full-blown war. Should the president be incapacitated or killed, that responsibility falls to the vice president, and so on down an established chain of command. Second, the president is patched into a conference call with his top civilian and military advisors, whom all recommend a course to follow. If enemy launches are detected, this call can last as short as 30 seconds. Communications between the president, his advisors, and top military leadership are all relayed via the U.S.'s MILSTAR satellite network, a highly jam-resistant constellation of satellites that keeps U.S. forces linked together around the world. As a redundancy or in the aftermath of a nuclear attack, U.S. military forces could still use the TACAMO airborne communication system to stay in contact. Basically, a fleet of airplanes packed with communications gear that is also extremely resilient to jamming. The TACAMO communication system was designed to keep a nation ravaged by nuclear war in contact with its military forces around the world. Once an attack plan has been decided on by the president, the senior officer in the Pentagon War Room must authenticate the president's identity by issuing a challenge code using the military alphabet, such as Charlie November. The president then references his authentication codes card, known as the Biscuit, and reads the appropriate response. An emergency war order is then broadcast to all U.S. nuclear alert forces via several communications networks to ensure receipt. The order is typically about 150 characters, or the length of a Twitter message, and contains the specific war plan to execute, launch time, and authentication codes needed to unlock the missiles before firing. Seconds later, crews around the world based in missile silos, alert hangars, and submarines deep underwater all open locked safes which contain sealed authentication systems, or SAS codes, which are prepped by the National Security Agency. They compare their SAS codes with those contained within the launch order to verify the authenticity of the launch order. Any discrepancies whatsoever will result in a no-go or no-launch release of nuclear weapons. When launched from a submarine, the captain, executive officer, and two other senior officers authenticate the order. About 15 minutes later, the missiles are ready for launch. Land-launched ICBMs are housed in underground silos with five launch crews each controlling up to 50 missiles. Each launch crew is made up of two officers, and the individual teams are housed miles apart from each other in highly secure underground complexes to ensure their security. Each team receives their orders and compares their SAS codes with those sent by the war room. Once authenticated, the crews enter the war plan number into their launch computers, which retargets the missiles from their peacetime targets in the middle of the ocean to their wartime targets on land. At the designated launch time, the crews all turn their launch keys simultaneously, which sends five votes for launch to the missiles. Because the missiles need just two votes for launch, failure to authenticate or mutiny by three other crews will not stop the launch of all 50 missiles. Missiles launched from airborne platforms follow a similar method, with their individual SAS codes being verified against those sent by the war room. During the Cold War, the US and Russia both kept nuclear alert forces in the air at all times, 24/7, 365 days a year, and these crews would then immediately proceed on a vector to their assigned targets. Once SAS codes are authorized, missiles are immediately fired. Anywhere from 5 to 15 minutes after a presidential order is given, intercontinental ballistic missiles will be blasting off into the sky to rain death down on their assigned targets. And once released, there is no way to recall them, disarm them, or reprogram their trajectories. The responsibility of carrying the nuclear football is staggering, as is the responsibility of the man entrusted by the US to use it properly. While many have criticized the entire system, and one senior American general was even discharged for asking, "How do I know the president giving me the order to fire my weapons is sane?" It remains the best system for ensuring continued nuclear deterrence. If the president is always connected to the nation's nuclear arsenal, then there's no reason why your personal website shouldn't always be available everywhere you go. That's why we use Wix. Wix offers mobile support, so your amazing website will always load lightning fast on any device. And you know that site's going to be amazing looking because Wix offers over 500 fully customizable templates to build your site with. And for the more advanced designers out there, you can take advantage of Wix's robust and easy-to-use design tools to make your own. Check out the link in the description below, or go to wix.com/go/infographics and browse their ready-to-use templates. Then get started designing your own killer site. Think you could handle the responsibility of handling the nuclear football? Should there be some way of ensuring the current U.S. president is actually sane enough to order a nuclear strike? Also, be sure to check out our other show, USA vs. the World. Who would win? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time!